Hey there, it's Katrina Sawa here, the Jumpstart Your Biz Coach with jumpstartyourmarketing.com. And today I want to talk to you about marketing. I want to talk to you about the different types of marketing that are going to be good for you moving forward, because marketing changes a lot. As you can tell by social media, if you're on Facebook, they change stuff all the time, right? So we have to be up to date on what's going on, what we need to do, what we need to not do anymore, and how to really effectively manage our marketing so that we're getting in front of enough prospects to bring in the right leads to funnel them through our sales process and get to a paying client, right? So that's what marketing is. It's the marketing is before the sales process. It's the lead generation and also follow up, and then it leads into the sales process. So what I want to talk to you about today about marketing is I talk about it in a couple different ways, okay? But for my next live event, which is happening in April, it's the Love and Money Live is the name of the event, where we get more love in your life and money in your business to create your ultimate lifestyle business. I'm going to be talking about the online marketing versus offline marketing. And the reason I break it up that way is because there's you got to do both. You got to do both. But there's a lot of people out there that who talk about marketing strategies and they only talk about online. And I think that's a huge mistake, because some of the offline marketing is where I find the majority of my clients and where I'm at multiple six figures in my business is because of the offline marketing. Okay, so if you're just starting out, or if you've been in business for a while and you've been trying the online stuff and it's not really working, or maybe it's working to a certain extent, which is great, it should be to a certain extent, but there's some offline stuff you need to be doing. Let me just give you a couple ideas, okay? So speaking is one thing you can do online and offline, right? So that should be your number one marketing strategy, no matter what you're doing and what your business, frankly. I don't care if you're a housekeeper or a massage therapist or a financial planner or a coach or an author, you should be speaking about your business, or at least speaking and teaching something and having them know what you do from stage, okay? So if you're scared of speaking or public speaking, we gotta help you figure out how to get over that. We do. But speaking offline is like in person, right? You can be booked for a speaking gig, like a meeting or an event or a conference or even a meetup or some, you know, it can be anywhere from 4 people to 400 or 4,000 people, right? I usually speak for a couple hundred people or less on a regular basis. It's not as easy to find the hundred audience, the multiple hundred audience or the thousand audience these days. So you don't have to be too scared. Usually you're in a room full of 20, 30 people that want to like you, right? So it can be more comfortable. But speaking in person at events, now you can host your own events. So if you aren't finding that you're getting booked often in person, why not host your own meetup and once a month and have a meetup and get up there and talk and teach something, right? I do that. I actually have my own meetup too. I've been doing this business for 16 years and I have my own meetup, people, okay? Because it does bring leads into my business, into my events, and into my coaching programs. You can host your own 2 or 3 day event or a 1 day event, a retreat or whatever. That's still speaking in person, all right? So speaking online though, we're talking video right now. I'm doing a one-man show, kind of one-woman show here on video. And then I post this video in various places. I put it on my YouTube. I put it on my blog. I'll put it out to social media from the blog post and or in my email newsletter. I'll link to the video, to my blog post. Everything kind of gets repurposed, right? And then there's interviews and guest interviews on radio shows, podcasts, video TV shows these days. So you can get booked as a speaker on telesummits and all kinds of different things online, right? But you should be creating your own as well, okay? Don't just wait to get booked. If you need speaking gigs, create your own speaking gig. So create a teleclass once a month or a video class or a video training once a month. I started doing Zoom trainings this year. And so if you're not aware that I'm doing them, I want to say it's the fourth Friday of every month, starting in 2018, except for the holiday months, November, December, I think it's the third Friday. But the fourth Friday every month from 9 to 11 a.m. Pacific time, I'm getting on a Zoom call, and it's basically open coaching hours. And so whoever shows up, whoever decides to come, my regular clients are invited for no charge, but it's a low price fee to try me out for coaching and get some really good advice for where you are now in your business and get you that jump start that you need. It's only like $79 right now. So I can't guarantee what the price is going to be later, but right now it's $79. And if you're interested in that, to check it out, you should attend one so you see how I run it, and then you can do the same thing. Right? It's a very easy and free, it's free, mind you, it's a free way to attract people to you, get them talking to you. Zoom, well, it's not totally free. If you do a call that's over 40 minutes or it takes more than 10 people, yeah, you're going to have to pay $14.99 a month for Zoom. Okay. But that's minimal to have that kind of a platform. I love Zoom. I love video. I love to be able to just talk at you and tell you what I think or interact with people. And instead of going somewhere in person, it saves a lot of time for you and me, for me to be able to sit in my home office and just talk to you that way. So the days of the coffee meetings are gone, you guys. Okay. Don't do a coffee meeting when you're driving all over town. You got an hour in traffic there and back or whatever. And then you have the coffee and then you're distracted by the waitress or whatever. Or people are running late and you're waiting. 3 or 4 hours could be a coffee date. That's just ridiculous when you can do stuff on Zoom. So you can create your own teleclass, webinar, Zoom, masterclass, coaching, training, whatever. You can choose to have people on or not. You can pre-record it or not. Do your own thing once a month. You'll find it's helpful for list building. It's also helpful to get people to trust you, like you, and connect with you so that they might be ready for the next step sooner than later. Because anytime you can interact with them, either in person or like this, is going to speed up that sales process. All right. So do something virtual speaking as well as in-person speaking for your business, please, and your marketing strategy this year. All right. There's a lot of other things I teach about online and offline marketing. Oh my God, I teach about 20 different strategies, and I'll try to bring more to you this year. I really want to do a lot more how-to tips, but you got to come to an event. That's where you get the majority of the content. My binders are chock full of lists and checklists and even scripts of things that you need to do and say and send and email and all that kind of stuff. I'm very how-to oriented at my live events. I highly recommend you check them out. If you go to livebigevents.com, that takes you to my website, my event page, right? So there's a calendar there. You're going to see the live events every year. Usually, right now I have 4 this year. Usually I do 3 or 4 live events a year that you can come to, and they're various themes. Okay. But all of them are going to help you get a jump start on your business online and offline, really. There's the master classes. They're on the event calendar as well. So there's one every month. You can just pick it, sign up, and come to a masterclass and try me out. But don't wait to get that jump start. Don't wait to put more marketing in place. Don't wait to get the right marketing in place and the follow-up and sales processes. I can tell you in like 1 hour usually or less the 3 or 4 things you need to spend your time on this year in your marketing, and you can be done. You can be focused and just driven and ready to go. Seriously, stop waiting around. Go to livebigevents.com and I'll talk to you soon.